As an instructional method, paper writing is old and obsolete. It's the way people were educated back before we even had computers. Over-reliance on paper writing preserves the status quo in American higher education. Over the years, people become complacent. This is true in all industries, including the higher education industry. Over-reliance on paper writing in American higher education gives native English speakers an unfair advantage. If you say everyone should write their own papers, you're like one of those intolerant white nationalists who get scared of immigration. We live in a globalizing world now, and a lot of linguistically diverse people need degrees just like the rest of us. It's nice for you if you grew up speaking English, so it's easy for you to write papers. But for some people who learned English as a second language, it's very difficult to write papers, and it takes a long time. And they're already working a lot of hours just like you do. So in the digital age, you know, having perfect English grammar is not as important as it used to be. Writing papers is not as relevant as it used to be. The overuse of paper writing is an instructional method that perpetuates the hegemony of native English speakers in an increasingly diverse American workforce. A resourceful English learner might decide to even the playing field by using a paper writing service. Over-reliance on paper writing as an instructional method in higher education gives verbal and auditory learners an unfair advantage. Some people learn well by writing. I'm one of those people. But others learn well by doing. Hands-on kinesthetic learners. It's also called haptic learning. And then other people are visual learners. Through over-reliance on paper writing as a curriculum requirement, American higher education unfairly gives the advantage to the verbal and auditory learners like me. But the people with all the power feel fine about this. The investor class needs to limit the number of working class people who can complete degrees and elevate themselves. So there's no incentive for the people with influence in our society to do anything to change this problem in higher education. If you're taking an online class, a lot of the time that you spend writing papers has nothing to do with your field of study. Academic writing is all about learning how to use APA style citations and format. It's useless. Using APA style is meticulous, tedious work that must be done just for its own sake and without any application to real-world professional practice. There is a whole book written about how to use APA format correctly. I bet you have had a professor who's a real stickler for correct APA. Of course you did. We all did, because nitpicking a degree candidate's APA is an easy way for a professor to give the obligatory criticism without investing any real thought or energy, without giving any kind of substantial, meaningful feedback. Did you ever ask yourself why paper writing is used so much more than other instructional methods? Even now that technology has made new possibilities available, still we use paper writing the same as we did 100 years ago. Well, asking someone to write a paper is a strange way to teach them something, but it's a great way to make the student do all the work while minimizing the work and expense for the business. And when I say business, I'm talking about the school that is selling the degree that the consumer needs. Imagine how much more time the professor would have to spend if she or he used an interview assessment or a problem-based or project-based assessment or instructional method rather than requiring a paper. The professor would actually need to spend several minutes or an hour with each student. An interview or a problem or project-based approach would be a great way to teach or evaluate, but it's rarely used because it's a lot more work than assigning papers. Paper writing services are not unethical because American higher education is already screwed up and it already involves way too much paper writing. The rising cost of tuition is part of the way the investor class exploits the working class. They don't just exploit them through labor, they put the working class people into lifelong debt before they've even entered the workforce. If you're already part of the workforce and you need a degree, you should do whatever it takes to achieve that goal. Life is hard. This is not a game. Working class American rat racers are trying to survive and thrive. Not all of them will be able to complete a degree.